Hi everyone, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. So in this week's video, which is the last of the series of videos on liver function, jaundice and viral hepatitis, we will be doing a survey or a questionnaire on some of the Singaporeans or some of the patients in my clinic about their knowledge and awareness of viral hepatitis B. Some of the questions that I'm asking would actually be taken from this paper that was published in a journal of Gastroenterology and Hepatology, published on 14 March 2021, titled Public Awareness and Knowledge of Liver Disease and Health in Singapore. Okay. If you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe and notification button now. So let's go. Question number one, hepatitis B is a bacterial infection. True or false?
True.
True.
Right, so the answer actually is false.
Oh.
Hepatitis B is a viral infection. It is not a bacteria. Question number two, hepatitis B can be prevented by vaccination. True or false?
True.
True. True or false? True, yes. So both ways, I really got it right.
Yes, there is hepatitis B vaccinations available.
Great,
yeah.
So bonus question. Do you know how many doses of hepatitis B vaccination is required for protection?
I think it's two.
Okay, the exact answer is three. Okay, so in Singapore, all newborns are subject to a mandatory three doses of hepatitis B vaccination to be protected. Question number three, hepatitis B can be transmitted by eating contaminated food. True or false?
True.
False.
Yes, so Mrs. Tan is correct. Mr. Tan, you are wrong. Hepatitis B can be transmitted only through contact with blood or bodily fluid. It cannot be transmitted through eating contaminated food.
I see.
That would be hepatitis A. Question number four. Hepatitis B can cause liver failure or even liver cancer. True or false?
True.
True, that's correct. Hepatitis B can lead to long-term liver inflammation and in the long run causing liver failure and even liver cancer. Question number five is a multiple choice. Which of these four choices are wrong? Okay, which of these four is wrong? Hepatitis B can be spread through mother to child during delivery, A. Contact with the blood of someone who has hepatitis B. C. Sharing needle or razor blade with someone who has hepatitis B. And D, mosquito bites. Which is wrong?
D, mosquito bites.
Right, okay, great. So the answer is D, mosquito bites. Viral hepatitis B cannot be spread through mosquito bites. Some of the common infection that can be spread through mosquito bites includes malaria and dengue, but not Hep B. Question number six. How do doctors like myself test for hepatitis B virus infection in my patients? A, through a blood test. B, through stool test, and C, through ultrasound of the liver.
I think it's blood and ultrasound.
Alright, you are not wrong, but the correct answer is actually through blood, okay? So we actually use blood tests to diagnose hepatitis B. So some of the blood tests that we do include viral hepatitis B surface antigen and hepatitis B surface antibodies. You are not wrong also to say ultrasound, but we don't use ultrasound for preliminary diagnosis. But we use it to follow up patients who has already been diagnosed with hepatitis B.
Yeah, it's to check for the liver like damage.
To check for liver, whether there's long-term inflammation, whether there's swelling as a result of the Hep B infection. Mm-hmm. But you're not wrong to say ultrasound is one of the options. Okay, great. Question number seven. Can hepatitis B cause lifelong infection? Or is it just simply a very mild infection like flu that you can just recover from easily?
Lifelong.
Lifelong, good. A, lifelong infection.
A.
A, okay. Again, both of you are correct. Hepatitis B can cause lifelong infection. In fact, the chance of it is actually even higher in children. 90% of infants who catch hepatitis B from their mom actually has lifelong infection. Question number eight. Are there treatments available for chronic hepatitis B infection? Yes or no?
Yes.
No.
No, okay. The answer is yes. Okay, there are medications now available to fight the hepatitis B virus. And there are also medications on trial now to prevent hepatitis B from actually replicating in our body. But these are still very new medications that needs to be properly evaluated. As you can see, the general public's knowledge of viral hepatitis B is still lacking. There are a lot of misconceptions about the risk factors and complications of viral hepatitis B, and definitely more medical education is needed to be shared to the public. If you are watching this video now and you are interested in finding out more about the liver function and viral hepatitis B, please feel free to check out my previous three videos in the channel and you can learn more about it. Thank you again to all my participants in this survey today. Till the next time, stay safe and stay healthy.